Let's take a look at the changes from the PTV coming to the update next week, starting with the Twins rework. The devs have actually listened to the feedback, and they decided to revert the changes they gave them in the PTB. So Victor no longer latches into downed survivors, and instead he latches into healthy ones. They also removed the haste effect, since it now doesn't make much sense, as it would buff Charlotte while a survivor is carrying Victor. They didn't specify if you can still kick Victor after a successful attack, which would be a huge buff, but nevertheless, they are keeping the quality of life changes they introduced in the PTB, making this still a net buff instead of a nerf. Twins were already considered to be one of the strongest killers in the game, so hopefully with these changes aimed at making their gameplay experience better, their pick rate will increase, even if it's just a bit. It's still sad that this is all the Twins mains got after years of waiting for the fabled Twins rework, but this is the best case scenario after the mess that the PTB was, so I am happy that they did revert the changes, and I am sure many Twins mains are happy about it too. The Blight got two of his add-ons nerfed, both being the add-ons they changed in the PTB. I still stand by what I said, these add-ons are boring compared to the original design, and I didn't notice them being any fun or strong in the PTB. So the fact they nerfed these instead of nerfing the other add-ons of Blight is just funny for me. They also said that they will be improving on the collision of Blight across all maps, and hopefully this also helps other killers like the Huntress or the Xenomorph's Tail. Decisive Strike got its animation removed, and now instead it's a net buff of 2 seconds, making it a total of 5 seconds stun. They say this is because the animation had an effect on the perk, and I would argue that's not the only problem it had, since the animation looked horrible. I wish other perks got buffs instead of Decisive Strike, since this perk was already meta for years, but it's true that Decisive Strike was an empty perk slot against the top characters in the game like Nurse or Blight. And finally, they did a weird side grade to Ultimate Weapon. Now it makes survivors scream again, but this time, it now only works 32 meters around the locker that you open, instead of the previous terror radius condition. This is a nerf, since you can no longer move around the map in order to find survivors, making builds like the one with the pig as well as the one with the Oni considerably worse. However, this is also technically a buff, as stealth killers are able to use the effect of the perk. More in specific, Xenomorph can actually use it now, as its terror radius was smaller. I personally think this is a huge nerf, and it's no longer the best tracking perk in the game. And these are all the changes they did from the PTB. The store changes are still coming, as well as the nerf to Adrenaline, which is honestly not that big of a deal. Not gonna lie, this is one of the most mid chapters I've had, since the amount of hype I have for it is basically zero. Nothing changed besides the cool cosmetic store, but I am still happy with the last chapter, since I find Unknown super fun to play, and Sable, as well as her perks, made me enjoy Survivor again. Let me know what you think in the comments, thank you for watching, and have a nice day!